I'm working with the saddle with Atlas today. So I just have this old cheap saddle that I got. It is definitely not something that I'm going to strap to his back. It's just to get him used to it. So I just want him to kind of see it. There, he's a little scared. I just kind of wanted to get it close enough where he could kind of see it and touch it. And I did have it already out here before I brought him out, so he could kind of come up to it and see it on his own. And he was not super worried about it. He was just a little worried when I brought it closer to him. But now I'm just going to have him target it, and every time he targets it, I'm going to click. So here I'm going to click, and then I'm going to feed him a reward. So at first, that's what I want to start out with. So we approach it, he sees it, and then we're going to target it on the ground, and then I'll do the same thing while I pick it up, and then I'm going to take it away while I feed. So he's looking at it, I'm clicking, and then taking it away, and same thing. So same thing, he's going to look at it, click, take it away, and then feed him. And then I'll have him touch it and do the same exact thing. So bring it back. He can touch it on his own. I'm going to click and then go ahead and feed him. So just introducing it to him to make sure that he's totally cool with it. I'm not going to just whip it out and put it on his back. Some horses are okay with that. That's possible, but not Atlas. Atlas is very sensitive. You can see even when I was moving on the ground and he had a little startle. So that would be too much for him. Possibly with a horse like Dakota, that would be okay. But even with her, I'd want her to see it on the ground a little bit, kind of get the process of putting it up on her back. So me kind of swinging it up there would be important as well. And then actually having it on her back. So, and really now I like to do a lot of targeting, especially with the horses. So like right now you can see that I'm targeting and he's targeting it with his nose, but I'm talking about like the horse brings themselves to the saddle. So that's what I also would like to work on later on. This is just going to be the introduction before that. So we'll work on that later. But that was just a side note as far as quickly introducing it or to a horse that's a little bit more brave or not as worried about things as Atlas is. So the reason that I'm saying that this saddle is not going to actually be on him, it's cheap. It's not suitable for his back. It's not suitable for any horse's back. So if you see like the gullet there is really narrow, it's just not made well. But you see how what I'm treating it as? I'm just going to throw it on the ground and like do whatever. That's why I have it. So, and I want Atlas to get used to like, oh, he sees it and it flops on the ground and it's not a big deal. Same thing like if you watch the series with the saddle pad, the surcingle, like anything that I'm putting on their backs, like I throw it on there and then I pull it off and then the pad flies off and it goes underneath them and it hits the ground. I want him to think from the very beginning that that's just how those things behave and it's not a big deal. So if I sneak around, then he'll be a lot more worried than when it does blow off or it does fall down, and that's just something I don't want. So at this point, we're still working on targeting, and then I'm just dropping it on the ground and feeding it straight. So just a little different dimension to that. So and I'm waiting here. You can't really see, but I'm waiting for him to come and touch it because I'm kind of in the way. But then I can just toss it on the ground and he's used with that sound and the saddle flaps around and stuff. So, and then I'm gonna touch it on his neck. And really when I voice this over, this video is like a year old at this point. And like what I was saying about targeting is I would like him to touch his face to it. I would like him to touch his neck to it, to his shoulder to it, his back to it. At this point, what I was doing before is I was waiting for him to kind of like look at it, and then I was going ahead and touching him with it, and that can work as well. But I think I want to do a little bit more, especially specifically with Atlas, is a little bit more participation on his part, because he does have a lot of worry and fear in there. Like with Dakota, with Castor, I had them targeted a little bit, like up to their neck, and then they were cool with it. And if you've watched Castor's or Dakota's videos, like they could care less about the saddle. So like if you see here how I hit the saddle on the railing there, and he didn't move a muscle. So that's what I was talking about a little bit earlier, where if I'm not super careful and I can just kind of flop around and drop the saddle, drop the pad, and I've hit these poles a million times and he doesn't care. So that's kind of the point there, is just kind of throwing around and being loose with it and getting the horse used to that from the very beginning. So, and then I've kind of moved on. I am kind of using a start button as I'm waiting for him to kind of touch the saddle, and then I touch his neck, then I touch his neck a little bit more, a little bit further down, touch his shoulder. Now you can kind of see him touching on his wither. So we are using a start button, just a little bit harder to see. So like I'm holding it, there he's touching it, and then there you're putting it out. So that one is important too. The reaction of the horse after he's touched it, you can see he kind of quickly touched it and then brought his head up. So he's still got some tension in there. So at this point I could be going a little bit slower. I could, and that was why I was saying that I think Atlas is better suited for him doing all of the targeting on his own, not necessarily just the start, but you can see his reaction again. Same thing there. He kind of brought his head up. He looked a little tense. It's just maybe a little bit too fast for him. So when I do it the other way and I can just kind of hold the saddle and he comes to it completely on his own, I think specifically that would be best for him and build up his confidence. So I've just asked him to stand here, grab some food. And you can see my cue for the standstill is just I touch him on the forehead and then I still stand, tell him to stand. So throw some food in here. But so I'm going to be experimenting with him doing a lot more body targeting up to the saddle. But this is kind of where I started, and this will work for some horses. But if you do see this like tension in here, then I would try to do the other stuff and try to have them come to the saddle a little bit more. I could also at this point break it down a little bit more. So I went pretty quickly from his face to his back, and I could have done that a little bit slower as well. So I'm just gonna have him come with me here and follow the target. But I could have started with he targets it with his face, and then I touch him on the neck, and making sure that I'm reading that body language the whole time because there was a little bit of tension in there that I just didn't
Good
see,
boy.
or I was too worried about saddles go on the back. So I'm gonna just keep going till we get to that point. So just some things that we could work on, but I'm gonna give him a little bit of a break from that and let him follow the target. He's quite good at that. Going around the round pen here. My camera situation's a little bit weird, so unfortunately, it's gonna be like traveling. This is about as good of an editing job as I could do with this footage, but luckily, there's only a few videos that have this. Everything else before I switch cameras, or after I switch cameras, is much better than this. But I thought that the content was good enough, so I went ahead and just used it anyway. So it's important to kind of take breaks in between too. So like we're just gonna work on some like basic like lunging essentially. So I'm gonna have him and some voice cues. So I'm gonna have him walk forward with like before me. So I'm asking him to walk on. I do a point, like a point up with my arm, and then he goes ahead and goes forward, and then I follow him. So I wanna just be aware of that because I don't want him going off of me going forward. See how he moves forward, and then I do, and then I just have that target to kind of have him follow it. It doesn't have to be over the rails or anything. So I want to work on the trot. See how he kind of did it a little bit there, and he does a little baby trot. So we're gonna just work on that. But again, it's important to just take a break, do something else, especially if it's something a little bit easier for the horse, so they can have a little bit of an easy thing, and then it kind of builds their confidence, and then they can go back to that hard thing. And that's another thing that I had to learn, just kind of by doing, so it's easier if you know it from the beginning.